ఆదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశర్షభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదం టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ హెల్త్ వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్స్ నంబర్ 23 ఆఫ్ 6th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ తం విద్యా దుఃఖ సంయోగ వియోగం యోగ సంజ్ఞితం సనిశ్చయేన యోక్తవ్యః యోగో నిర్విణ్ణ చేతస. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ ఇస్ గివింగ్ ద డెఫినేషన్ ఆఫ్ సమాధి. టోటలీ హీ హ్యాస్ going to complete with the last one which we began from verse number 20. Then the next he told was Atma Darshanam, self-identification. The third one was Atyantikam Sukham, complete happiness, unlimited happiness, the happiness never go once you attain. The fourth one is Tattva Nishtha, వ్యావహారిక దశాయాం బ్రహ్మ నిష్ఠ బ్రహ్మని స్థితః. దట్స్ వాట్ వి సా యాజ్ సహజ సమాధి. తత్వనిష్ఠ మీన్స్ బీయింగ్ ఫర్మ్ ఇన్ ఆత్మతత్వం. ఫిఫ్త్ వన్ వాజ్ ఆత్యంతిక లాభః, గ్రేట్ ప్రాఫిట్. దెన్ ద సిక్స్త్ వన్ ఇస్ ఆత్యంతిక దుఃఖ నివృత్తి, ద రిమూవల్ from the sorrow or detaching from the sorrow. Now in the seventh definition he gives the meaning of the word samadhi as yoga, as Patanjali alone. Patanjali also gives the same meaning. He also used the same word. The word is known as yogaha. Yogaha means there are so many meanings. According to the root verb, yogaha means to make or to connect or to join. So when there are two things are coming together and merging with each other called yogaha. But one more meaning is samadhi. So this jivatma paramatma yogaha, where it is taught, that can be also called yogaha. Now yoga asana, it has got the different meaning. To coming together and becoming one is known as yogaha. But in the samadhi, he gives in different way the same meaning by removing sorrow. So you gain yourself. Now yoga samknitam, this is known as yogam. It is said as yogam. So it is said as samadhi, that which separates you from the connection of the sorrow. It's a dissociation from the association with sorrow. Is known as samadhi. The seventh definition, dissociation from the association with sorrow, means what? From the birth we are associated with sorrow. We don't know how we made it. It's very difficult because it's very subtle too. When this body is not our swarupa, but we superimpose on this sharira, that is me. It's very critical, clever superimpose. It is impossible, but we make it possible. We cook a food, But there are so many factors are involved. The weather should support you, the fire should support you, the cooker should support you. Cooker means pressure cooker to support you, but you say that I cooked. Did you cook? You just put together, but you won't. You superimpose, we superimpose on the so many factors, we want them all together. We just proclaim the ownership. So where our ownership is not okay with, we say, I cook, I did, I constructed the building. Who constructs the building? The house owner says that, I construct building. Engineer says, I constructed the building. Mason says, I constructed the building. Architect says, I constructed the building. Who constructed the building? Nobody says that, all we together constructed the building. If at all they say, all together we constructed the building, what about the gravitation? What about the materials? Who produced the materials? And who is holding that? That is the center of gravitation. If there is no gravitation, no brick will stand one on another. Then we proclaim on all the forces as though we do. It is a superimposition. We superimpose everything without the sense or with complete cleverness. Isn't it? So we adjoin with all the activities which we cannot proclaim the ownership, but we do. There where we are making ourselves as a successful businessman. We are successful businessmen. We proclaim our product, which is known as I-ness, mine-ness, I, me, myself. Wherever I go, I. So I am the doer. Then, if anything is provided, any profit, it has to be me. Then, all the things must be enjoyed by myself. I, me, myself. Whole life is I, me, myself. We contract ourselves with unnecessarily the things which are going to be decay. That's what wrongly we put ourselves. But this yoga, samadhi, the process of samadhi, in which we are detached, we are removed from the conjunction, from the connection of the sorrow. That's what samadhi is. Samadhi means it separates us, it dissociates us from the association of sorrow. It means it is the best formula to keep ourselves, with infinite ourselves, to dissociate with finite sangha. We get associated with infinite swarupa. That's what samadhi is. Therefore, here he gives one more clarity. This samadhi is not going to provide anything. It allows you to be you. Or in detail, it removes the wrongly understood the things. It doesn't provide you. And people think we gain the bliss by the meditation. Meditation cannot provide ananda. This is like a doctor cannot provide health. He removes through his meditation the obstructions of the health. Because our real nature is a healthy nature. Therefore, when we become, again, when we get health, we say we have become one nature, swasthaha. Okay, that swasthaha is our nature. Like that, the disease which was caused by ajnana, that ajnana is being removed, we gain ourselves, means samadhi is not providing anything new. Samadhi removes something which was veiling ourselves from ourselves. Now that is removed. That is called a dissolution of something. We have to realize the seven definitions of samadhis. We have to study again and again to assimilate what samadhi is. The Vedantic meditation's benefit is nothing but samadhi. That samadhi has the seven kinds of definition. So those definitions will help you to realize more, and it will give the clarity about the process of meditation even more. With that clarity, we continue to the next words. Sankalpa prabhavan kaman tyaktva sarvana seshatah manasaivendriya gramam viniyamya samantatah. The next words. Now he brings back once again dhyana swarupam. Till the last words he was giving the definition of samadhi, which is the benefit of the meditation. Again he brings dhyana swarupam. It means when you sit in the meditation, what is the process to be taken place? And that process also he says as though a kind of operation. Operation means you don't think you are with the scissors and knife. No, it's a kind of the things to be taken place. That's what he says. Sankalpa prabhavan kaman tektva sarvan aseshatah. See, he brings, you have to be at present. Your mind should not jump to past, to future, again past and future. It is the tendency of the mind to wander between past and future. You have to withdraw from that. But the language of Krishna is so technical, we have to understand properly. He says, sarvan sankalpa prabhavan kaman aseshatah tyaktva. Giving up all the desires when they are in the baby state, in the seed form, at that time itself, you have to remove them or drop them. The desire of the future. Always we desire. Any desire, it is for future. But backed up by the past. See, past will help us to set the desire. Expectation will help us to make the effort for the desire. Now the past, the mind which is sticking with the past can set the future, but at the samadhi you should not making the plan for 5 years or 25 years. At the samadhi means when you practice meditation for that at least 20 minutes or half an hour or 1 hour, you have to be completely free from your planning attitude. When you started planning, then you cannot be at present. Being at present is the most important thing for the meditation. Because the mind, when it goes between, you know, past and future, it won't allow you to contemplate on anything. If at all you are contemplating, it will be the fake meditation. Therefore he says, all the desires are backed up by the past, which includes the expectation of the future. Now you have to be careful enough with your past. For the time being, you just keep your past as the past. Don't make it, don't connect with the present. Present is pleasant. Therefore, you have to be pleasant with the present, so that for that you have to drop the past at the present. And the thoughts which will make you too happy, because sometimes, you know, when we sit, Even in the cave, even in the room, whoever is not there, nobody is there, only you are there. You also locked everything, you kept your mobile out, everything you switched off, laptop was switched off, everything off. Then you make your mind, you determine to sit for meditation. After sitting for the meditation, your subconscious mind will rise with all the thoughts of the past. And also it will bring superb plans during that time. You have to slowly make the process. You have to be confident. You should not lose the confidence. That's what's said by Krishna in the last verse itself, in the second line. Anirvinna chetasa nischayena sahayoktavyaha. Slowly with the firm mind, the mind which is not disturbed, that mind which is endowed with optimistic, not with pessimist, and with the undisturbed, undispersed mind, this meditation to be taken place. The process is very subtle. You have to be very careful, because all the desires, they just arrive in the form of the seed. When it is in the form of the seed, they are weak and feeble. You have to drop them. That is easier to drop when it is in the seed form. Once you allow them to grow as a tree, you cannot slay them. Then you have to struggle more. Therefore, when you sit for the meditation, you don't allow to bring active past. Okay? And at the same time, if you are getting any desire, just remove them. So how can we do, Swamiji? For that, we need to have practical things to be done. You sit in the place and close your eyes, just to relax as we prepared in the Bahiranga Antaranga Sadhanani. You just keep yourself very relaxed and keep your eyes on tip of the nose. Everything that was said in the beginning, you follow everything. Now, you just be as the witness for your thoughts. Don't wait for any vritti or thought. Don't be carried away by any thought. The same thing I told long back, I think two chapters ago, or in the fourth chapter, I suppose. You just practice. You just sit there, but don't wait for any thought, and don't be carried away by any thought. Just sit. So sometimes you will be carried away by the thought. So how will you drop it? Just you realize, I have been carried away by the thought. The thought will drop from you. You will remain in you. That is the way you have to get rid from these all the desires. Okay? And don't engage your indriyas. Don't engage your indriyas means some people, they light the agarbhakti. The smell of agarbhakti keeps engaged with your nose. The nose indriya, the sense of smell will become active. It will keep working there. Some people, they are playing the music, means your hearing capacity will become busy with that. Don't make it. He says, manasa indriya gramam viniyamya samantataha viniyamya. Organizing all your group of sensory organs with the mind. With the mind means the mind which is not shaken. You have to be confident, because it's a very challenging job. You can conquer the world. It's very difficult to conquer you. The mind has got the potential capacity, no doubt, but if you want to organize it, it will become a rebel. it will become like a rakshasa. It will become, or it will create the hell for you. So you should not lose your mental peace or patience. At the same time, you should not become mad. You have to be very careful with yourself. We have to be relaxed and confident. It's the operation to be done during the meditation. He says that it has to be in slow process. Don't lose day by day, week by week, month by month, even year by years. No matter, don't leave it. Lagatar, catch hold with the practice. So 5 minutes means make it very less time. Don't make it too much time. Sit for 5 minutes and observe yourself and do some pranayama. Because when you sit for meditation, even normally when you sit for the meditation, immediately you are not turning yourself. You cannot. If at all you are sitting in the class, after coming into the classroom, you cannot turn all your attention. So you still, you might be thinking something happened on the road, or your mind which was left on the flyover, or somewhere some conversation, mind still working with that conversation. It will take some time. When you sit for the meditation, you just keep yourself silent. Don't do with your mind. Don't make any effort. Be relaxed and with closed eyes, being straight, having your mind focus on the tip of the nose. Just be for 5 minutes. Don't do anything. Relax. Everything to get settled. Then slowly you can start observing or being witness. Then you can shanai shanai ruparamet buddhya grati grihitaya atma samstham manah kratva nakinchitapi chintayet shanaihi shanaihi uparamet buddhya grati grihitaya buddhya shanai shanaihi uparamet. Slowly, with gradually, you have to make effort. So once 5 minutes, sit for 5 minutes and increase for 10 minutes. If your mind is imbalanced with emotions, don't sit, wait for your mind to get rid of that. Any emotions, it may go slowly by the time. Certain emotions, as you become matured enough in the meditation, you will come out of any emotions very soon. Therefore, if your mind is occupied with imbalanced emotions, you have to wait. Don't sit for meditation, but don't lose the patience. You keep going. Atma samstham manakratva na kinchit api chintayet. So when you sit, just you allow your mind to stay with you. Don't allow the mind to be engaged with some conversation or some incident or accidents or some with omissions and commissions. Don't allow. Be at present. That is very, very important, because being at present itself is the gift. Because planning for the future, you can plan later on. For the time being, you just disconnect that to next words. Yato yato nischarati manaschanchalam asthiram tatastato niyam yaitat atmanyeva vasham nayet. The mind may go towards the object, towards indriyas, towards some sukha. Don't feel bad. Yataha yataha nischarati. This mind is chanchala yuktam. It is fluctuated alone. It may go and get locked with so many things. You wait and you can bring back slowly the process called meditation. Tatas tataha niyamya yetad atmanyeva vasham nayet. As I told you, know, when you realize you are carried, you are being carried by a thought, just be aware of it, you will be back. This is what the process for all the meditation. First, we fix outer object, because so always you remember, Meditation should be began from outer world, not directly on you. You will become mad or confused. You have to select first outside. So you have to select anything as an object that depends on you. There are auspicious objects are prescribed by our Shastra. So like Om is an object, and the bells and the conch blowing sound. And not only that, these all mantras are very auspicious. Those all mantras, when you hear, you will get the vibration. Just you listen to the mantras, but you just focus on the core of the mantra, the cause of the mantra, or you can even meditate on the source of mantra, which is Ishvara. So you have to select object always outside, because mind always goes outside. It cannot be turned back immediately. You have to be firm. You have to gain the ability to stand with one object. Okay? Then slowly you can bring your attention. You have to keep changing the object. You should do with eyes. Sometimes you should do with ears. You should do with your touching sense. As I told you, no, long back. So fixing something on the head, you can see that the concentration, dharana practice, is the most important practice in the meditation. Without having dharana practice, you cannot come to meditation. Now he is explaining dharana alone in different words. Dharana means mind will go away, you bring back. Mind will go away, bring back on the particular subject outside. Then you can slowly come to you. Then you can try with the help of Vedantic technique, Vedantic words. That's what he continues, that we will see from next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.